Hey everyone, welcome to today's practice, and it is a yin yoga class. So I have some of the more classic yoga props that I'll be using, two blocks and a bolster. I also have a blanket that I'm using, and this is more of just a prop for my seat, for some of the seated posture, so this is very optional. And I am using a yoga blanket, but any type of blanket would work really well. Also, if you don't have blocks at home, maybe just gather in some couch cushions or a couple of pillows or something. They work really well. We don't need the firmness so much of the blocks. They're more of just like light pieces of support. So take a moment to bring in some cushions and pillows and things. I really like propping myself up in a yin yoga practice. I find that the more support my body has, the more of a signal that is sent to the muscles of my body to really relax and let myself sort of settle in to the different shapes. So because this is a yin yoga class, there will be long moments of quiet, like just total quiet. And I won't be playing music for the class, so if you would like to set up a little ambient something in the background, that could be a really nice accompaniment to your practice. And because of these long moments of quiet, I'm just kind of letting you know in advance, because it's on video, that you may encounter like a moment or a minute or two where I'm not speaking, and most likely the video has not paused. So you don't need to keep looking up to check that things are still going. I'm just not speaking. So there will be these opportunities for introspection and contemplation and quiet while you make these different shapes with your body. So we'll begin seated, and again I'm going to sit onto just a low fold of a blanket. This could also be done seated right onto the ground. You could be sitting onto one of your cushions. And I'll sit cross-legged. You can sit however is comfortable for you. So a moment to bring yourself into a comfortable seat. To either close the eyes right down or to steady a downcast gaze. Bringing your awareness into the different sensations of the body. And allowing whatever is there to be there. The yin sensibility is very much an attitude of allowance and acceptance. So we meet what is present with friendliness. Checking in now with your state of mind. Again, allowing whatever is there to be there. Meeting yourself as you are in this moment with open arms. Now begin to familiarize yourself with the natural rhythm of your own breath. Recognizing its sound and texture, where you feel it in your body. Like to set an intention for your practice, do that now. And then let go any attachment that you might hold to this thing. So we can intend towards something detached from the outcome of that thing. One of my favorite lines from the Tao Te Ching by Lao Tzu is, "This is the way of heaven. Do your work and quietly step back." Together, let's take a long breath in and an easy breath out. Your opening shape is butterfly pose. Again, I'll be doing this sitting on a low fold of a blanket. So you could be on a low fold or on the floor. And you'll bring your blocks or cushions in to support the legs. So the first hinge is a nice big hinge from the hip. And then allowing the spine to round. So it's very different than a more active variation. There's a lot of space between your pelvis and your feet. And you are allowing the spine to round. Taking some time to get yourself set up into your shape. That looks like adjusting the props and making some maneuvers in the body. So what you're looking for is to meet your first edge. And so that's a place where you are encountering some sensation in a way that feels sustainable, knowing that you will be here for a little bit of time. So the first principle in yin yoga is playing your edge. And the idea being that you don't have to go all the way right away. And you simply meet a place of sensation and stay right there. the work of playing with your edge is understanding that our edges are dynamic and constantly changing. So your edge in the morning will be different than that at night. From one day to another, through the cycles of the moon, through your internal rhythm. And the edges that we meet are not only physical. You might come up against a mental edge. You could come up against an emotional edge. And the idea really is to be respecting our boundaries. To not try to push or force through anything. This is a continual practice of meeting ourselves where we are and landing in that position. We'll be here for just a little bit longer. Allow your mind to land on the sensations that are occurring in your body. To roll yourself up. Pause upright and seated for a moment. You can move some of the props off to the side. Use your hands to gently gather your legs back toward one another and separate your feet a little wider. Let your hands rest to the floor behind you. This is done slowly, your knees wash from one side to the other. As I go to one side, I like to sort of puff my belly and my chest up, almost getting into just a little extension of the spine. These transitional moments are done with just as much care and attention as the held shapes are. And the next time you're at center, you can stay. So there'll be a few different options for leg positioning. You'll choose what feels right for you at this point. So the first is to extend the left leg and cross the right leg over. So you're set up for a twist, and you could stay like this. You could also fold in the bottom leg, as long as both sit bones are onto the ground. The next option is to fold the right knee directly on top of the left knee, and you're in cow face leg. So any of those leg variations, you'll all take a gentle twist to the right. Once you get your hands set up the way you like them, you can close the eyes down and begin to direct your attention and your breath into the low belly and the low back. force the twist. The breath moves down in a relaxed manner to the low belly and the low back. If you're pursing your lips or tensing your cheeks or tongue or jaw, and see if you can become more spacious in your mouth. Very slowly turn the body to center. And the options here are to keep your cow face legs and fold forward in your cow face legs. So that will look something like this, again, bringing in cushions and things to best support you. You could also take these cow face legs on your back. And so that would be laying just flat onto your back. Again, right knee crossed over left and holding on very gently to your shins. So taking a moment to get yourself set up to the position that best suits you here. Again, using the props that you have available to you so that you can then settle yourself down. So the first principle of the yin yoga practice is playing your edge. And the second is stillness. So we come up to that place where we feel sensation. I really like this phrase, it's often used in the yin world, that we come to a place of joyful discomfort. So the idea is to not grunt through pain. Feeling pain, sit up and adjust and find a new positioning. But joyful discomfort is to be able to sit in sensation with the second principle, which is stillness. And the idea is that if your body invites you deeper, you go. Your body asks you to back off, you back off. The idea with stillness is that you're not fidgeting as a function of the mind, fidgeting out of boredom or edginess. Open yourself to stillness. on your back. You can gently unravel your legs and place your feet to the floor. You can use your hands to unravel your legs. You'll sit with your legs stretched out in front of you. Stillness can be nice. I like to run my hands up and down my legs, even rub a little bit around my bum and my low back. And so entering into the second side, beginning with the twist. So again, right leg is extended, left knee bends, and the foot can cross over. So this is an option. You can cross the bottom foot under, again, so long as both sit bones can be on the ground. The third option is to cross the left knee directly on top of the right, so you're in those cow face legs even here. And you'll take a very gentle twist toward the left. And again, once you have your hands set up how you'd like them, settle down a little. And begin to send your breath softly to the low belly and the low back. If any tension has moved into the face, see if you can let that go. Slowly bring your body back to center. Pause here for a moment. And then taking the next variation of this shape, which again could be cow face legs sitting up and folding forward with some props, or you could do this laying on your back. Again, left knee on top of right, you'd be holding onto your shins, you'd be laying flat on your back. So take a moment to set yourself up again. Part of the setup is bringing props in. So working, again, with your first two principles, the principle of playing your edge. So taking the first few moments here to find a position where you are meeting sensation. And propped up in such a way, or supported even with the support of your own body, in such a way that you're able to open to the principle of stillness. As a tool for your mind to stay present in this moment, keep your awareness on your breath. And the sound of breath, the texture of your breath, where you might feel it in your body. Scan through your body and notice if there's any areas of gripping and holding on. See if you can let that go. Slowly roll yourself up. And you'll pause upright for a moment. If you're on your back, you'll unravel the legs, place your feet to the ground. And again, you might even use your hands. Gently unravel your legs and stretch them out. Stillness here, just breathing space into the back of the knees could feel nice. Or again, using the hands just to run up and down the legs. A little rub around the bum. And your next shape is Sphinx pose. So I'm going to show this with a prop. I really like doing this with the bolster. You might choose to do it with like a pillow, or you could do it with nothing. So I'll show you first actually the shape. So Sphinx is here. And again, in the yin style, because you'll be holding for a little while, having the elbows ahead of the shoulders can be nice. It just doesn't take as much work of the shoulder to hold you there. Even like something like this or this can be really nice. So with a prop, you'll bring the bolster snuggled right up into your body. It's right at my rib cage. And then here I am. And I will rest my head into my hands here. So there is some intentional compression being placed around the low back in the sacral area. If it is too intense, you can always back off. This is one of these poses where having just a little activation of the low belly or even a little activation of the low bum could help support that area. So you see what feels right for you. get yourself set up, you'll take your thumbs and you're going to place them just into the crease of the inner eye socket. And it's such a subtle piece of pressure there. Breath flows in and out naturally. Let that point of pressure go in just a moment to open your attention and awareness out into the space around you. Take your thumbs now and they go just sort of just to the outside of the nostril. There's like a nice little point there, and you very gently press inward and then a little bit of movement out, almost like you're gently guiding the thumb just a little away from center. You might feel that opens the sinus passageway there a little. Again, an easy rhythm for your breath. Let that pressure go and allow your attention to simply open out to the space around you. For one more minute, you can stay just as you are, or you can place your hands to the ground and straighten the elbows. You're now in what's called seal, and that will most likely intensify the sensation at the low back. So again, not looking to encounter any sort of acute sensation or anything that might feel painful, or there may be sensation present. Part of developing your practice as a practitioner is being able to discern which sensations to sit with and which to accommodate and find a new positioning. Down. If you had a cushion there, lift yourself up just high enough to slide that out of the way. and laying flat down onto your belly, and it might be head into your hands or one cheek to the ground. Taking a few really big belly breaths here. So this next shape, and I'm going to use my blanket just to support my knee on the hardwood flooring. If you have carpet flooring, it might be more comfortable. I'm going to take you through some steps. You'll take what you want and leave the rest. The first step is to take your right knee and you bend it out to the side. Once you get there, you can turn your left cheek to the ground. So it's almost like this half frog leg. And again, I'm breathing deeply into my low belly. You can stay just like this. The next option is to thread the left arm underneath you, and you'll keep the left cheek to the ground. So I am looking, rather than threading the arm too far underneath me, I am actually looking to lay pretty much on top of the arm for now. And again, my breath is going into my low belly. Again, the option to stay, or the leg that's straight, that's your left leg, that knee will bend. Reach back with your free hand, that's your right hand. Catch your foot and pull your heel in towards your hip. And the breath is going into the low belly. Attention to where you have sensation in your body. If you have caught the foot, let it go. Gently unthread the arm if you thread it. You can straighten the right leg back out. So you're laying again flat on your stomach. You might have your head to your hands or a cheek to the ground. A few big belly breaths here. If you want support for your knee, you can move the blanket over to the other side. And so the opening shape in this series is to take the left leg out to the side. It's bent out to the side. Again, it's like this half frog leg. You can have your right cheek to the ground. And it's those big low belly breaths. And even though you know where this shape could go for you, we'll give each variation of this pose its own time. So I'll let you know when to layer in the next options. You can stay just as you are or thread the right arm under. And again, you can have the right cheek to the ground and you're sort of laying on top of the right arm. Continue to breathe low down into the belly. You have the option to stay just like this, or bend the knee that is straight, so that's your right leg. You reach back with your free hand, that's your left hand, catch your foot, and gently draw your heel in towards your hip. If you have caught the foot, let it go. You'll slowly unthread the arm and slide the left leg back down. So again, you're flat onto your stomach, either resting your head to your hands or one cheek to the ground. Big belly breath. Yourself up to your hands and knees and then back into child pose. And if you're comfortable in a narrow knee child pose, you'll take that. So knees a little narrow. So the thighs actually provide a bit of a shelf for the torso to fold over. Arms back toward the feet, and this will allow a little more flexion of the spine. So forehead might rest right to the ground, or you might bring the blanket or cushion back in. You won't be here for too long, but long enough that you'll want to be comfortable. Allow your shoulder blades to melt away from one another. And imagine the breath coming and going from the space around the back of the heart. slowly roll yourself up. Pause upright for a moment. So you can lay yourself onto your back, and you are setting up for just like one last little shape and then Shavasana. So if you like to have a blanket behind the head, you might put that there. And you'll come down to lay on your back. And once you get there, gently draw your knees in toward your chest, and you'll let your knees go fairly wide. So you can tuck your knees into your elbow creases and lace the hands. You could do that. You could also simply hold on the shins and let the arms rest to the ground, but the knees are fairly wide and the feet just dangle. And begin to exaggerate the breath. So the breath is now intentionally longer and deeper. Feeling a movement of the low belly as you breathe. As if you could breathe into the pelvic bowl. As if your breath could touch your pelvic floor. Encouraging, opening to the current of energy that is down and out. Continue on with these intentional, low down, big breaths. Place your feet to the ground, knees are bent. Feel the weight of your body settle down to the floor beneath you and return to your natural rhythm of breath. The next shape will be Shavasana. If you feel like you need one more little hug of the knees in, any final gentle shape, take it now. And then Shavasana. And if you have some props around you, you might place a bolster or cushions or something underneath your knees. Cover yourself up. And allow yourself to approach Shavasana with the same amount of care as you've approached every shape leading up to this moment. Know that while you're here, there is nothing for you to do. Nothing for you to change or hide or fix or negotiate. Once again, you meet yourself as you are with an attitude of acceptance. Shavasana, you'll stay for as long as you'd like. Thank you so much for practicing. I'll see you tomorrow. Namaste.